I don't know what this thing's on yet because it's been a while. I believe How Little We Know, Beyond the Beef, and then probably Helping the Great Khans, and I might even consider doing one of the DLCs, but we'll see. Also, I'm probably going to get Pack Rat next. That actually is my perk because, boy, that would have some good uses for me. I should activate your quest arcade. I don't even know how much. I think I can talk Kushina and talk.
Nelson's back in our hands. Hope we can defend it this time.
Please, don't do that.
Just lost a month's caps.
I like what I see.
Of course you like what you see. Look at this. Look at this body of a god.
Just as a warning, my covert bandaging skills are a little rusty.
Hey, baby. There's me.
Whoa. What the fuck is this? Oh, I remember this.
More of this waiting for you inside.
But if I have a queue to try it out, like say I'm doing something else with the mod, and fuck it, why not?
Hey, no one but Omertas are allowed to carry guns into Gamora.
Okay. I wonder if Edie can still shoot their lasers, so fuck it. Oh, wait, the receptionist. Hey there!
Hello and welcome to Gamora. What can I help you with today?
I'm calling for an outstanding matter of information. Tell me what the Omertas want.
I knew someone would call in that mark soon.
Need to know what to talk to about what's been going on.
All I can tell you is to find Kachino. Some of the girls say he's been involved in some shady business the family wouldn't really like.
Hello.
Ask him about it.
Hey, playing for luck. What is that to do around here? Do you have any rooms available? I'm sure you have all the good dirt and what goes on.
I sure do. But loose lips? Sink ships.
Don't worry about me. I can keep secrets.
All right. You look pretty trustworthy.
It doesn't even help me. I already have my information. I just want to be XP.
Bosses don't like no trouble in their place.
Now, would Sheldon gamble a little bit before he went to this? Which is a moot point because I don't have any chips. Twitch viewers, look away, otherwise we get hacked.
I hear you've been asking questions about me, dickweed. Oh, no. What the fuck do you want?
Just call me dickweed. How would you be doing business on the side?
Business? What the fuck do you mean, business? You looking to get yourself burned? Now you start talking real clear, and I mean fucking crystal clear, because I'm about to lose my patience.
The Omertas won't take kindly to him about your relationship with Joanna.
Joanna? That bitch spreading lies about me. You've got a lesson to teach her about loose lips.
Too bad she's not here.
You again? What the fuck do you want?
Okay, I can check his room. Or his room be on the elevator.
Hello.
Up the elevator. Lower brimstone. I have any reason to go up. Uh oh, gods. Shit, a lot of gods.
Hey guys.
I got kicked out of Ultralux the other day. Man, that place gives me the fucking freaks. Holy shit, you've been in Lucky 38? You meet the big man in there?
Well, I can't open his door, so I'm gonna have to lockpick something or find a key. Let's have a look, see if we will. Oh.
King sold out to the NCR, huh? Might be worth a sit down with him.
Whiskey. Maybe your room has got a broken thing I can go for. Oh, don't mind me.
That's fine.
Pillows. I can't do anything with pillows. It's like a tool shed. There's nothing to anything useful in here. This is getting me nowhere. I need to get that key to his room, or I need to pickpocket him. Hello.
Bosses don't like no trouble in their place.
Excuse me, just looking at me on the floor. You don't have anything.
Don't mind me.
Maybe one of the prostitutes can help me out, I think. Maybe. I do not know. Ah! Door. Looks suspicious, but I don't think it's gonna help me.
I hope you're doing well, friend.
Thanks, buddy.
I'm glad they don't let just any motherfucker through the gate. Freeside smells like shit.
That's incredible. I'll just steal it off him. The game's a save, so I can try as many times as I want.
That's the spirit.
Yoink. Oh, no one stopped me. Time to read this loser's journal.
Yoink.
Documents a couple months of Kashina's activities. It contains a detailed letter describing many of his business deals over the last few months, including the sale of chems and weapons. It's clear at a quick glance that these transactions are his own personal finance. This is done behind the backs of the Merter family management. He also talks a great deal about many sexual encounters with the moral prostitutes. After nearly every offer book sale or sexual twist, he vows this one will be the last. Hey, I found a journal.
You again? What the fuck do you want?
I have this journal. Explain it.
Where the fuck did you get that? Okay, listen, buddy. That's some dangerous shit you got there.
Where did you get
that? That book can get me killed if the wrong
people
see it.
I guess he was hiding the book in his pocket.
Let's talk. What do you want? What can I do for you?
I think the family would like to see this.
I can't stop you, but that's gonna mean my death. You can make it worth your while to give it to me, though. Plus, if you go to the bosses, I can't help you stop what they've been doing.
Oh. I think I'm gonna keep this for a little while.
All right. I can't stop you, but I think we can help each other out. I know not at home in the NCR would be happy to get some dirt on the family. I can help you get that dirt. Hey, look who it is!
Hey, now we're friends.
Suddenly it's all cool.
Why don't you try and take it from me?
You wanna come into a back room and give me a chance?
No.
Didn't think so. Much as I'd love to put my fist through your neck, Mr. House frowns on that kind of behavior.
Instead of giving this to you for some cash up front.
Okay, you got me by the balls. Here's a couple hundred caps. Balls. Maybe that'll buy your friendship.
Hey, yo. It's worth 100 caps,
dude. I can pay you for it, of course. Between you and I, we can break up what they're planning. Maybe save some lives. Mine included, of course.
Yep. Okay, 100 caps, and you help me break up whatever your boss is at hand.
Oh, here's some caps. Now give me the journal. Right, there we go. So let me tell you what I know about the family's business. The bosses, Big Sal and Nero, have been working for a while on this.
Nero,
they're arming themselves
Tarzo.
Like an army, using this new guy, Troik.
His Latin notes.
They also brought in a specialist named Clandon. At least that's what they introduced him as.
What kind of specialist is Clandon?
I got no fucking idea. They let him have the run of the place, though. Seems like a nice guy, but he makes me nervous. He's a little arrogant, but he's too nice. Too open. I've never seen him fucking a gambler.
I will be
Everyone
back.
Has a vice, no but this guy seems like the Pope.
Yeah.
A couple more questions.
Okay, toss them at me.
Tell me about this Troik.
He's a skittish little fucker. Spends half the day pumping his body full of chems and the other half pumping hookers with his willy.
Willy.
He has some kind of connections, so he's able to smuggle huge shipments of weapons into the Strip. The bosses got him by the short hairs. We covered up a hooker he killed while flying on some psycho, so he gets his guns in exchange for not ratting.
Alright. Nothing about the plan?
No, just that it involves guns and muscle. Okay, you can find me here or upstairs in my room. I'll let the muscle know you're a friend of mine. That should let you get around a little easier.
Nice. Got a couple of allies in the place. And I do believe one of them's on the lower level, so let's start with the others. Yeah, always. Maybe you can laser beam anyone. Get some money up.
I hear the Legion is moving some tough muscle into the area. NCR better keep their heads down.
Hey, asshole.
Who are you? I didn't do anything. Leave me alone. Oh, man. I don't even like to think about it. All that goddamn blood. It was just in the hotel like any other night. I took some chems with the girl I was with, but I never black out. I did this time, though. Next thing I knew, I woke up, she was lying next to me, stabbed dead. There was a knife next to the bed, and I was covered in her blood.
You didn't do anything. You know where the knife came from?
I keep a little switchblade tucked away with me.
Okay. What kind of chems are you doing?
That night, mostly buff out. I like to cut it with a little bit of jet and wash it down with some whiskey.
It doesn't seem like enough to get you used to the whole night, so it's no
good. What? Yeah, you're right. I wonder what was up with that.
How did the family find out?
When I saw the body, I started screaming. In a few seconds, some of their soldiers were in there cleaning up the room. They offered to keep silent about what happened if I agreed to help them get their hands on large quantities of guns, at deep discounts.
They're just trying to get you out of the contract.
You'd do that? For me? I'm not sure what can be done, but...
So, let's check your room, huh? Let's see what you got.
I hear you chased that chicken shit Benny off. Good riddance.
You chicken shit, you Benny, you fucking no good schmuck. This is kind of me. Of course. This is a suspicious amount of blood. I think this is Troik's room. They're cleaning it up.
Okay. I'll do my best.
feel like... Hey, it is the men's room. Didn't feel like... Hey, asshole. Get the fuck up!
You ever seen one of those rangers in black armor? Hey, nice to meet you. Do you need help with something?
What did you do around it?
A little bit of this and a little bit of that.
I ended up in one of these hotels.
I'm a close friend of some of the family around here.
See no sandwich.
Ticino. Yeah, I've heard the name.
Need to get you.
Bye.
Well, he's up and about now. That's not exactly useful for me. Probably know that if I give it a double over. Reveal itself. Seems amount of blood in this room. More than a little bit of a scuffle, I'll tell you what. He's up and about, so it's kind of a moot point now, so probably.
What the fuck is that thing? Securitrons with faces like soldiers. Is this martial law or something? What the fuck?
Fuckers. Huh? Guess there must be in the room. Hello, Twitch. Yeah, 72. Nice.
You know you want a piece of this. Give me some sugar.
Maze, honestly, I'm gonna be real. Okay, that's for it. Everything else seems to point to being on the road. I'll be honest.
God damn, do I love this place!
What in tarnation? Level to this, so let's have a look.
Hey, what can I do for you?
That's kind of, can get anything.
I figured you might have that problem. That guy's pretty much a mystery. I did some asking around about him. Turns out the boss's plans are right fucked without him. Killing him would probably work wonders.
Good to know, actually.
Welcome back to Gamora. Find yourself a girl or a guy and have a drink. Your family. Second. Find yourself a girl or a guy. Have some fun.
There's something somewhere.
Whoa, the great Caesar is dead. Management doesn't seem too happy. Gamora is always open for business.
Howdy.
King sold out to the NCR, huh?
Yeah, talking this thing.
Sit down.
Go down the way, don't do it, and I don't know what the hell that is. What the fuck is this access? I stole that room from nothing. I stole that key from nothing, though. That's not good. Doesn't help me much. That could help me know. Thank you.
Good to see you again. Hope you're
Is this best bugged? I know this is a very easily bugged quest. I'm not entirely sure that the game wants it. The game that I've been since I've talked. Fuck me. Low levels. Get back and talk to Clem and then I'll just get big salaries for this contract. Sorry, big salaries.
That follower fucker is gonna have some trouble if he tries to liberate any of them.
You again? Cacino? Yeah? Well, fuck that. More power to you if you.
Welcome back to Gamora. Find yourself a girl or a guy and have a drink. Your family.
Hey, you're Cacino's friend. You got business with me? Sorry, but... Ah, Trike. What's he want? Some more jet? A fresh batch of girls? Maybe a guy or two this time. What, that he's a murdering jet head? Yeah, I see where you're coming from. Okay, tell Troik he can hit the rope. We run a hotel. All right, come back anytime.
Okay, that should be good. I have to throw that weapon shot.
Business is good. All the family's got money.
Of course, Gamora.
You again? Holy shit. Really? Okay, I'll help you. But I'm getting the hell out of here first chance I get. They're keeping them in a little utility section down off the basement. I don't know what they're arming themselves for. As a little pet project, I've been making some thermite. Thermite burns as hot as the devil's asshole and can melt through just about anything. I've been keeping it so if the family betrays me, I can hopefully do some damage before I end up dead or in jail. Okay, here's the thermite and a key to the room where I rigged the light switch outside the room to kick off a spark big enough to hold the thermite. As soon as we're done talking, I'm gonna make myself like a ghost.
to get the guns.
I'm pretty proud of myself. It's a stroke of genius, if I could be so modest. The whole arrangement starts with an old buddy of mine in the Republic. He's responsible for packing and shipping supplies to the NCR on the Strip. He marks some containers as food and medical and packs them with guns and other shit. From there, it took just a couple of greased palms to get someone to let me cherry pick a container or two out of every shipment.
Okay, a couple more questions. Where do guns come from?
I've made a lot of contacts over the years. I have some friends back in California that can get their hands on just about anything. Mostly, I've been calling in every last favor I have.
That's it.
Okay.
I'm taking this shit with me. Okay, got everything I need.
What's up?
Alright, this thing's gonna be some good. Come on, come on, Wolfie.
Fiends are bad for business. NCR should do their fucking job.
Hey, what can I do for you?
Shoot up the guns.
Whoa, you managed to pull that off? Solid work. That ought to gum up the boss's plans.
What's the next step?
Now we cut off the head of the serpent. Big Saul and Nero have to die. Hurry and get ready.
Oh, so the key app definitely makes it.
You know you want a piece of this. Give me some shit.
I hear you've been making some waves around here.
Oh, that's it. Perfect. Down in this problem on that fucking shit. The states contain horrific sounds of... Oh.
I hear the NCR and the Kings have been getting along. Good to see you again. Hope you're...
Seriously? Ah, oh, fuck it. I'll just read that stuff. I didn't get all that much anyway. I'll get them in. I'll get them in. That's That's real fucking annoying.
Prim has a new sheriff. That should keep the powder.
I'm just sorry I had to be there to say, but I do not want this guy to die. This time I'm so fucked up for sure.
Whoa. Hey, what can I do for you? Yeah, this is Clandon. This guy's one sick motherfucker. The way I see it, you have a few options. Maybe you could use what's on these tapes to get him by himself. Or maybe you could use him to leverage him out of the casino. I hear the Legion is moving some new tough muscle. There's some serious shit going on between NCR and the Legion. You better not fuck with our power.
Good to see you again. Hope you're... I think I should kill you before you have a chance to show those tapes to anyone. I guess you've made your choice then.
You like that?
Damn.
I got kicked out of Ultra Lux the other day.
Morning. You again?
Contracts, get those guns, because there's some good fucking guns in there. Light no thing on fire, tandem dark flaking, yeah. And cannon. Cannon first, please.
What the fuck?
Hey, you're Caccino's friend.
Find yourself a girl or a guy. Have some fun.
You again. Thermite is a mix of rust and aluminum dust. If you add a little heat, a massive amount of heat is spit out. It gives off enough heat to melt through just about anything.
Hey, what can I do for you?
Shoot up the guns. Cannon is behind.
Oh, is that so? Well, I can't say that I'm sad to see that fucker gone.
Next.
Now we...
That's when the boss is gone.
When they're gone, I'm gonna run this joint.
I need to take care of the boss.
They're a little bit upset about what's been done to muck up their plans. They tasked me to find out who's responsible. There isn't gonna be another chance to get both of them together in the same room.
You're doing something for me. But they're going to accept something from me. You can do it and surprise them.
All right. I'll take care of them.
Let's go to take care of the boss. God, dude.
King sold out to the NCR, huh? Might be worth a sit down. Hey, I'll take care of them when you're ready. Just say the word. I suggest doing it while they're talking. You get... Hey, what can I do for you? Hey, what can I do for you?
You got something you need?
Hey, you're the one everyone...
That I could go, unless Christina picked it up. Damn, there's Hugo. I guess Casino really does.
Business is good. I know the family's got money. Of course, Gamora is where the action is. The fuck are you looking at?
Oh, you took it.
Sure. Just don't treat me like a pack Brahmin, okay?
Hey, thanks for all the hard work back. Of course.
All right, time to spend more. Shit. Oh, it's only in the Caesar's Legion safe house. Oh shit. I just figured we'll get that not tonight.
I tell you, not at home was gonna have his day.
Okay, now please for the love of God give me my guns back. I hope nothing fucked up and I lost my plasma cluster, because that would fucking suck. Yeah, that did.
Sure, just don't treat me like a pack Brahmin, okay?
I promise nothing and deliver less. Items in their home. Now, of all these weapons, interesting, it's the Bugsy Energy Rifle. Might honestly just be.
Have a nice day.
Hey.
Sure, just don't treat me like a pack Brahmin, okay? Knuckles. I suppose we can throw them in the melee thing. Combat knife can sell, that can sell, I don't care about these things. Oh, hunting rifle, go back. Good stuff to sell. Sure, just don't treat me like a pack Brahmin, okay?
We'll be on the beef next, and then we'll go do those great carny cons.
Sure, just don't treat me like a pack.
Sir Orman.
Let's get this so I can repair power armor. Oh, there we go. Oh, the 4770 goes in there. That's a bit annoying. I can't do anything like that. That's a good reason to start collecting casings again.
Thank you for visiting New Vegas.
Sure, just don't treat me like a pack Brahmin.
I probably should have taken more weapons away. Yeah, this is not any way to be healing my health.
Beg your pardon, but could I trouble you to turn over your weapon?
Sure, here you go.
My deepest apologies for the slightest inconvenience. You have my assurance that everything will be returned upon your departure. But we simply can't have anyone waving their weapons around in the hotel. It's not the atmosphere we wish to cultivate. Please, enjoy your stay.
Things are getting stranger every day.
You watch yourself around, Mr. Gunderson.
Beg your pardon, stranger, but I'm looking for someone. You ain't seen a young man with dark brown hair and a white hat on.
No, I haven't.
Ain't nobody got one darn piece of news about my boy. Not one lousy speck of information. Ain't got one Brahmin unaccounted for across a dozen ranches. But I'm here for an hour, and my own son just...
I should put a gun, lads, on
...made me a special arrangement with the hotel. They want to do business with me, they got to play by my rule. A lot of people out there resent success. Might want to take a swipe at me. This makes them think twice. If I'd have been thinking, though, I'd have had him watching my boy instead. Then none of this would have happened.
What's your son?
My boy, Ted. He was right here. I didn't leave him but a minute. I told him to stay put while I talked some things over with the White Glove folk. He was never one to stay tied down to a spot, though. Got most of my staff out looking for him now. I'd be out myself, but I keep hoping he'll show up back here. Of course, if he does that, I'll whoop him till his skinny hide turns to leather for putting me through this. But that don't mean I wouldn't be grateful.
Let me help you find yourself.
I'd be more than happy to have you. Heck, I'll hire anybody with a pair of legs and at least one good eye at this point. There'd be a lot of money in it for you if you can get him back to me safe. And if he ain't, you can bet I'll pay for the names of the sons of bitches responsible. That's what they call themselves, the folk that run this place. Some of them got masks, too. Real hard to trust folks like that. I don't talk to none of the other ones.
Let's see. Here is, yep, down the hall.
How may I be of service, sir?
What's about your organization?
My, such a popular question. I suppose it is only natural to see us and wonder what it is that makes us special. The White Glove Society has only just made itself known to the public, of course. But our pedigree was established over generations. Were we always so refined? I'd be lying if I said yes. But I've always felt we were destined for a place atop modern society. Not everyone can wear the finest clothes and eat the finest foods, obviously. That's just the reality we live in. But surely we can agree that the most tasteful, sophisticated people are the most deserving.
Goodbye. There go my... Oh, hey,
how do you do? Welcome to the Ultralux.
Look, there's someone who went missing recently.
This again? I thought this was all settled. I answered every one of that investigator's questions to his satisfaction and gave all the help I could. I know our reputation hasn't always been spotless, but that's all in the past now. How some people can't get over it is beyond me. For the last time, the White Glove Society has never and will never consume human flesh for any reason.
Whoa, you used to eat human flesh?
Now, didn't I already tell you that we don't do that sort of thing? Though we haven't always been the White Glove Society. There was another time, a dark time, when we went by a different name. But that's all changed now.
It's okay, I eat it now. What did you talk about? Who just talked about the disperse?
There was an investigator who came through here last week. He'd been hired by a young man whose bride-to-be went missing during their stay here. Well, you can already guess what probably happened, can't you? It seems perfectly likely that she got cold feet and ran off. And that young groom just didn't have a clue.
You know, you could talk to this investigator.
Why, yes, I think so, if he hasn't checked out yet. I had our maitre d' Mortimer offer him a complimentary room for as long as it took for him to be satisfied. You see, the White Glove Society remains the very picture of courtesy. Even in the face of such impolite accusations, we have nothing to hide here.
This is going to someone else, a man, and he just recently went missing.
A man? Well, this can't be. Two disappearances in my hotel? What will people say? I'm going to have a word with my staff. Whether these people are found or not, our guests simply must feel safe in their own room. Ta-ta.
Mortimer, hopefully. Morty.
How may I be of service?
Heard you keep grinding diamonds on human flesh.
Ah, yes. I've heard that one too. Jealous people say such nasty things. I feel sorry for them.
So it isn't true?
I can assure you that the only thing the White Glove Society is guilty of is preparing the tastiest cuisine you'll ever sample. That is, of course, if you can afford it.
Aren't you said you gave humans to private investigator?
Private investigator. Ah, yes, I remember the gentleman. This was about the missing bride. Such an awful thing. If I might pry, have you found something that will help his investigation?
Actually, I just need to speak with him.
Of course, of course. Now, ordinarily, we don't give out guest information, but I think, given the circumstances, he'll want to speak with you. Let's see. He hasn't checked out yet. If you head back to the hotel rooms, his will be one floor directly above you after you exit the lobby.
Got it.
I hope we can put this whole matter to rest at last.
Like that? You like that?
Shit, I don't think I'm gonna make it. Don't have a weapon on me. Right, one hair either.
Come on. Had enough. You like that?
Where to find one. Wasting time.
Those Freeside thugs aren't worth our time anymore.
Oh, no. I'm gonna have to go through Lucky Fit yet and get a hold up weapon. Useless. Brass knuckles and knife.
that very knife.
Did you know the Strip's all stirred up lately?
Just a second. I don't even have to go home. There's that holdout guy.
Look, friend, don't get near me.
What?
You're fucking...
You should see this place at night.
I have. I'm gonna get a stronger weapon for security than that. I think this might be one of the toughest fights I'm going to have in this game because it's using a skill I don't like. Well, that's not true, I don't hate melee. It's definitely not a skill I'm trained in by any means. That'll do.
Beg your pardon, but could I trouble you to turn over your weapons?
Oh.
My deepest apologies.
Oh no, I got the weapon. Never mind. Whoa. Damn glove off. Alright, 32 damage. That should be decent enough.
The Legion better watch out now. Our Rangers are gonna turn the tables around.
They must have spent a fortune renovating this place.
Yeah, so. Excuse me, folks, I am eating every now and then, so. I have to excuse me to an extent.
Who's there?
Shit.
Come on.
I'm hit.
Well, that did it. Fuck. Overweight, unfortunately.
Our victory at Nelson's a worthy story to tell him.
I'll take this little opportunity to eat a bit. I think there's poor water to kill my health. That's sanitary. There's always a chance you see him now, but I doubt it. Delicious pool water. No? Yeah. I just have to wait for him to arrive physically then, I suppose.
Who are you?
Someone who found the matchbook.
Matchbook? What about the man I gave it to?
He's dead.
Oh my goodness me. They must know he was talking to someone on the inside. They'll be watching everyone closer now. I knew this was a mistake.
Who are you afraid of?
Mortimer. If he realizes it was me the investigator was planning to meet, he'll have me killed.
So Mortimer's behind the disappearances then?
Yes. The White Glove Society strictly forbids eating humans. But we weren't always the White Glove Society. Mortimer and some of the others have regressed to the old ways. They've taken many people over the last few months, but always from Freeside or secluded places where they wouldn't be missed.
Oh, shit.
It wasn't enough. Lately, they've gone for tourists here on the strip, even in the hotel.
Holy shit.
I guess that's the hazard of a cannibal becoming a gourmet. It's hard to please a refined palate.
Cool, that, I guess you could say... I don't know how to discuss that. What were you supposed to discuss that?
The girl, the one who disappeared. I know what happened to her.
How do you?
Because I distracted her fiancé while they took her. Well, I'm not proud of it, but I had to. They could see I was having second thoughts. Some of the White Gloves began meeting privately a while back, started talking about how we'd lost our identity. I started attending because I thought it was about changing our politics. Then they started talking about returning to the old ways, and there was no way out. Well, they'd kill me for the things I heard them say.
Well, you fucked up there. My sympathy. What happened to Ted Yonison?
He's alive, as far as I know. They're trying to keep him fresh. Mortimer has special plans for him. The White Glove Society has a banquet every night at 7.
Shit.
It's in our private section. Mortimer wants to reintroduce humans into our cuisine. Since eating people is a crime we punish by death, he's going to do it in secret. After everyone has eaten it, he'll tell them. With no real way to punish everyone, in Mortimer's mind anyway, their minds will be open to the idea of eating people as a delicacy.
Oh, wouldn't they punish Mortimer for the deception?
They might. But to him, the legacy of returning to the old ways is worth his own life. I don't think he expects it, though. I don't either. Nothing is more important to the society than being on the cutting edge of New Vegas cuisine. Mortimer's idea will appeal to that need. He just has to get them over the taboo.
But they keep him, Ted.
I don't know exactly. I wasn't in on it. But you can bet they're keeping him near the gourmand. Our chef, Philippe, has an obsession with fresh ingredients. It'd be back in the members-only section. So you. It's guarded both at the lobby entrance and in the access tunnels leading from the main restaurant.
Anything you can do to help me?
I could sponsor you as an honorary member. The White Gloves are always looking for people who can elevate their status.
I'd appreciate it.
You'd certainly fit the bill with everything you've done around here.
My fame was.
Otherwise, you'll have to find some way to get inside quietly.
Ted's father's wealthy, man. He should be able to stop this.
That may be true, but I wouldn't recommend it. He's built a reputation. And it isn't for calmness and impartiality. He's not what he looks like. They call him Hurricane Heck. The man built his empire by hiring mercenaries to drive off the competition. Lately, he's been attacking our Brahmin suppliers so he can take over their business. He's the sort to pound in a nail with a wrecking ball. If you give him the whole story on this, he'd be liable to raise the entire hotel. And God knows what he'd do to the rest of the strip.
Just enough to get Ted out?
Well, they'll all be sampling pre-war wines before the meal. Maybe it's as simple as drugging them. Although, that wouldn't stop any future kidnappings. You'd have to expose Mortimer. But he's going... What if his revelation were a lie? Oh. What if no one had eaten human flesh but him? If you could somehow replace Philippe in the kitchen and serve a convincing substitute, you could walk Ted right through the middle of that room after Mortimer speaks. And then he'd have some explaining to do. Philippe has been trying to approximate the taste of human flesh for years.
Oh.
Let's plan on meeting again as soon as... Wait, did you hear something? Were you followed?
Shit! Fuck! Just for the sake of it, it'd be funny. Let's go put it on the board. You'll have a good evening now, you. Well.
I heard they brought in sea salts from California, just for this bag.
You know what? This is a little embarrassing. He's had a rough day, ladies and gentlemen. Why don't you slip back in now? No one can see you.
I heard they brought in sea salts from California just for this bag.
I heard they brought in...
Yes. Did you hear it from the other people who said it? Fucking Christ. I'm sure Marjorie is a sponsor. Oh.
Any idea how somebody gets into the White Glove Society? Have to know somebody.
Well, I'd be down to give you a membership for a laugh, but I don't think that's it.
Welcome to the Ultralock.
I want to join the White Glove Society. I was told I needed a sponsor.
Why, yes, of course. The White Glove Society is the most exclusive club in all of New Vegas. Perhaps the entire world.
Not a stretch,
it's only natural that you'd need a sponsor from within the club who can vouch for your good name. Originally, we didn't allow anyone else in, you see. Founding members only. We thought exclusivity would make us the envy of everyone. And it has. But then I had the idea to allow honorary members. Lower in status, naturally, but it just makes people want to be up. Uh-huh. And the right people could certainly do wonders for our image. Celebrities, philanthropists, we want only the very best. And you most certainly fit the bill. Given your deeds on the strip alone, I can safely say that you would be a prized addition to our honorary ranks. You have my full support, and you are welcome to join us at our nightly banquets.
Oh, formal wear. Formal wear. I can give that to Veronica and she'll teach me that scribe thingy. Oh.
Those omertes, always plotting, never relevant. Bravo for putting them in their place like that. Being an honorary member isn't the same as being a real member, but it still makes you better than everyone.
Greetings.
Hello there. Welcome greetings, sir. My survival should be high enough.
Why are you standing still? Do you think the world waits for you? I thought I told you to get lost.
Let her talk, and she's playing out a cookbook?
What, me? The supreme ruler of the Nevada dining scene? Teach some low-life half-wits how to make food that doesn't smell like burning excrement? Do you think it would sell?
Yes, for a major publisher. But as a sign of good faith, I need the best.
You're pushing your luck. Here, I have a few copies on me. We're gonna have a real problem if this thing isn't a hit.
Got it. The predisposition towards anger suggests unresolved issues in your past.
What kind of harebrained fucking psychobabble bullshit is that? I yell at people because I like yelling at people, and because they fucking deserve it, not because Mumsy and Daddykins didn't hug me enough.
Maybe projecting. Tell me more about your parents.
Oh, I see how it is. You think because my father walked out on us when I was five, now I have to yell at people. Or because my mother was a deranged chem fiend who regularly brought strange men home who told me to call them uncle. Or because my sisters would lock me in a shipping crate when they didn't want me around. And my brother... God, I'd forgotten about that. How could they do that to me? I can't stay here. I need to be alone. How could they treat me like that?
How may I assist?
I'm 7 o'clock.
But no one is in their chairs yet. Surely we should wait until 7. I'll be ready when you...
My daddy's gonna kill all you bastards once he finds out.
Calm down, I've come to get you out of here.
My daddy's? God damn it. I almost died in here. Who did this to me anyway?
So name is the White Ghost. They were gonna eat?
What in the Sam hell? Eat me? What kind of sick bastards would... I'll tell you what. As soon as I'm out of here, and my daddy knows the story, you can bet there ain't gonna be no White Hat Society no more.
In the entire society, just Mortimer and a few others.
To hell with that. You've seen those freaks. They deserve what my daddy's gonna have coming for them.
Always leave you there if you want to know.
All right. But there's gonna be some justice one way or another. Let's go. Come on, move it.
How may I... How may I...
Food. And you can see in that little bar if you look at the compass. Game is not entirely. From this wall, we just do everything about this. It's just like that.
Found you.
Shit. Look. Thank you.
I know I'm not the scheduled speaker, but I have a few words, if I may. There was a time, not so long ago, when we were bound together not as members, but as family, as a clan. And when Mr. House came to us with his proposal, we accepted, knowing we stood to gain much. Little did we know how much we'd lose in the process. As a society, we've endeavored to sample the finest food and drink the world has to offer. But we are living a lie. There is a meat sweeter than the most corn-fed livestock. Most of you have tasted it. All of you have coveted it. Among us, it is a crime to discuss a return to the old ways that unified our people. Tonight, that all changes. The taboo ends. Let me finish, Marcus. You don't know it yet, but you are all now guilty of a greater crime.
That happened.
There was a time not so long ago when we...
Oh, if he finishes the speech list, doesn't it?
Aha!
You like that? Had enough?
Come on!
This didn't work.
You, what do you think you're doing?
One of us sent me to move the kid. I think one of us had a microphone.
First he's too trusting, now he doesn't trust any of us. Bad out of the senses. And I suppose caution is the desirable course at this point.
I know I'm not the scheduled speaker, but I have a few words, if I may. There was a time, not so long ago, we were bound.
Phew! I did it.
Oh my God, Ted! Are you all right?
Quit your holler. I'm fine.
You got me my boy back.
I did it.
I got no words. Now, I hope you didn't do no harm to whoever's responsible for this. I want to skin their hides myself.
There's more to me. One of the white gloves that Ted taken. He's a cannibal.
Well, that does it. None of them maniacs will ever do business with Hank Gunderson long as they live. Hell, I'll put me together a damn blockade. Hit him where it hurts. They control the food? Well, there ain't gonna be no food. Not for anybody in this whole damn town. It's a goddamn monument to inhumanity. Let them starve. Biggest favor anyone's ever done this hellhole.
That's just what they'd want. You'd be driving the city to each other.
I don't like this place. Whole strip, really. Ever since I got here, the stink of it has flooded my nostrils. But you got a point. They're already hell-bent on depravity here. All I'd be doing is helping them along. All right. Well, I promised you I'd make it worth your while. So here you are. Try not to lose it all at the same casino.
Survival where it is. Let's start working on what.
You done right, brother.
You know, if you knew what you were doing, I could have been out of there hours ago.
So this doesn't give me sub. Don't tread on the guy.
Don't you just love that platinum chip? Buzzes with power and possibilities, doesn't it? If I were you, I'd almost want to deliver the chip to Mr. House, just to learn all its tricks. That is, unless you want to bring the NCR or Caesar's Legion to power, I wouldn't want to tell you what to do.
Let's talk about the tribes you get tonight.
Please, go on.
Boomers are vowed to support me.
Really? Talk about diplomatic skills. I mean, just not getting blown up was a success. Now they'll only blow up the right sorts of people. That's what matters. That's one down, four to go.
The Amazers are plotting to destroy the Strip, so I killed the conspirators.
Wow! That is amazing! You are just a hero. I am serious. That's two down. Three to go.
Spoke to Marjorie Mortimer. I say leave the White Society. The White Glove Society had a cannibalism problem, but I solved it.
A cannibalism problem? Really? I'm so glad you weren't eaten. That's three down. Two to go.
Great times in the Brotherhood. Something happens in the house, I'll be in touch.
I'll be waiting right here.
Partner, good to see you again.
What's up? Let's go make trouble. Ooh, got something good for me? Is it a dress?
Yes, indeed.
Darn it. A bunch of shit? Ooh, got something good for me? Is it a Hey, you got a
What is it?
The Brotherhood is failing. I've always known that. If we don't change course, we're going to fall apart or fade away. But until recently, I haven't understood where we went wrong or how to fix it. I think I need to go home.
I'll take you back there first once again.
Great, thanks. For me?
Yes.
Do you mean it? No, no, it's too much. Well, okay, but it's too much. Oh, it's perfect. I wish I had something to give you. Wait. What about punching? That's the gift that keeps on giving. I can work on your punching with you, if you like.
Sure.
All right, put him up. That chip of yours? Ooh, got something good for me? Is it a dress? Nice.
Beyond the beef and how much we know done. We consider whether or not we're gonna end it here. You know what? I think I will probably end it here for now. Actually. Found the two casino quests. We've got some more cooking to do, and we're gone. So, if you enjoyed me for the stream, and I hope it wasn't too long.